The sleep field is very young. Amazingly, it's not taught in medical schools. And this is surprising because this is something that every human being does for a third of their life. And so what I'm excited about is to bring this kind of sleep research to UCR. In my research, we investigate how memories are first learned and then how they're transformed into long-term memories. We try to manipulate the internal state of the brain using pharmaceuticals in order to see what's the most important aspects of sleep that helps with memory consolidation. What we're finding is that very specific features of sleep can be enhanced with specific pharmaceuticals. We use a specific technique called electroencephalography. EEG measures large averages of electrical activity. And we use both the behavioral performance from training to testing to see how does the brain signals change when they are just learning something to when that information is moved into long-term memory. And how does the brain's activity during sleep support that change? The question then is, are these changes in memory related to these changes in sleep in older adults? So what we're going to start doing is look at all of these different cognitive domains that we've been testing in young adults and see if we can stop or at least slow down these memory declines. A lot of our research focuses on napping because a lot of people nap. So if this is something that we can harness, this kind of power of this nap, can we then get people to improve in their performance, feel better? Can they nap better? Can we actually use the nap in a way to enhance people's lives? Since we can pharmacologically enhance sleep, can we then prescribe specific kinds of sleep in these naps? And would that just prescribed nap actually boost people's memory performance?